Hello everyone, in today's video, I'll be showing you on how to go from this to this. If you guys aren't already subscribed, please make sure to hit that subscribe button. I will be linking below where I got this idea from, as well as all the materials I used. This project is perfect for Foxwood, aka IKEA furniture. There will be no need to sand down anything. First thing we need to do is prep our furniture by removing everything on the surface. Then we will wipe down the dust with a damp cloth so we have a clean surface to work with. If your furniture has any hardware, this is the time to remove it. When my cat was teething, he was biting everything, and here is the culprit. I am using this wood putty to patch up all the corners that my cat bit off. And if I'm being completely honest, this wasn't the best product to use on this project. I had trouble making it stay and it would stay on my fingers. Although I did manage to figure it out, I don't think I will be using it again. Maybe a better alternative would have been to use caulk. If your furniture is white, you can skip this step. But since my furniture is an olive color, I'm going to paint it white to have that as my base. I already had this paint by Behr in the color Bit of Sugar. And I will be doing one coat of this to my furniture. If you want to be extra safe, you can do two coats. I didn't find that necessary. You will let the paint dry according to your paint's instructions. Once dry, I'll be using this gel stain by Min Wax in the color Aged Oak. To apply this, I used a foam brush, but you can also use a regular brush. I believe that's the best route. I just used what I had in hand. To apply this, you will be very generous with the product. More is better in this case. In the instructions, it does say to leave for 3 minutes and wipe off excess. Disclaimer, I did not. I don't want to do a second coat, it's all preference. I just want it to be done as quick as possible. Another reason I did not want to wipe it off, it was because I was loving how the color was coming out. You will also let this dry for 24 hours, or how much time your gel stain says so. Now for the top coat, I used Varathane in the finish Crystal Clear Matte. I went with this one because it is superior scratch resistant, and this is a medium traffic furniture, and I have cats, so I wanted a very durable top coat. Yeah. If you guys purchase this, be careful when opening. To apply this, I used a paintbrush and tried to do even coats and make sure there isn't any bubbles. This top coat required 3 coats, just follow your instructions. You can see my boyfriend in the back helping me cover all those cords. He used the cord cover to make it look clean and not messy. It's the next day and now it's time to decorate, which I've been waiting for. And now I'm just moving my furniture back to the wall. I'll be putting back the same knobs. You can also switch them if you want a different look. Now, I'll be using this basket I grabbed from Target about 3 years ago. If they still have it, I can link it. If not, I can link a similar one. But yes, I am using this basket to hide my internet box and DirecTV box. books from Goodwill for $4.99 each. I love shopping in Goodwill. You always find unique pieces there. I grabbed this vase from Home Goods for $9.99. I actually have an olive tree outside my apartment, and I went ahead and cut some branches and placed them in the vase. Here you can see me putting back the chair and the cat scratcher. I'm also placing this DIY vase I made on the bottom to add some height. I highly recommend these DW home candles from Marshalls. These actually make your home smell amazing. I'm just placing the candle on top of the books to add some more height. I'm adding this mini stool to the middle to fill in the gap. And this is the finished project. I hope you guys learned something today. If you guys do try this, make sure to tag me on Instagram. I'll see you guys on my next video. Have a wonderful day. Goodbye.